charter members here at the Healthplex about 11 years ago. We both joined the Healthplex when they had a trailer set up out in the, it wasn't even the parking lot at the time. We both joined when it was just a construction trailer out there, and we've been friends ever since. Still consider him a good friend of mine. I appreciate all that he's done. He was a very giving, kind, generous man. He did a lot of things for the community. He did a lot of things for the Healthplex, and as far as, you know, being my friend, I feel like he was an inspiration to me. I always told him I wanted to be like him. He was my hero. I wanted to be like him when I grew up. I wanted to be old. He'd look at me and he'd say, Finch, you ain't never growing up. I said, I hope not. But I appreciate y'all coming out. As y'all know, Dick was riding on the trace, and for some reason, he ended up in front of a truck. The truck ended up hitting him, and those injuries sustained took his life. Don't know why he ended up in front of the truck. As we all know as riders, rocks come from the road. You know, we have flats. We bump a bike in front of us. Bug gets in our eye. We may have a senior moment. I not yet, but eventually I'm sure I'll have some myself. But for whatever reason, we know that we need a certain amount of room, a certain amount of space. And in the spirit of what we're doing today, we've come up with an idea like other states have. We want to push through, give them three. Like, 3 feet is not enough, but 3 feet will help, okay? So what we want to try to do is springboard this. We've already done some things with the legislature. We've already met with some committees. We've got a great idea here. Whether it's law or not, it's still a great idea. We can still ask motorists. The thing for our ride today is give them three. We've got a quiet zone. All right, we're going to take the bike. This is the bike that he was riding. We're going to put it on a post in the middle of this quiet zone. All right, we're not asking anybody to stop, anybody put out flowers or any great memorial type thing today. But when you get to the give them three sign on the side of the road, it's just a quiet zone. The bike will be on the left going out, on the right coming back. There'll be another sign on the left, give them three banner. All right, be the end of the quiet zone, and there'll be a rest stop. For the 20-mile people, you can turn around and come back then. Just ride a bit more, ride a bit more. Be careful on the U-turns. All right, and then as we continue north on the trace, we'll get off just before you get to the interstate. Right as the bridge starts for the interstate of I-55, the Ridgeland Multipurpose Trail is on the north side of the Natchez Trace. There'll be a little section there, anywhere from 2 feet to 5 feet, that's gravel and grass. We'll get onto the multipurpose trail, go down to Highland Colony, cross over the median safely, turn left to go on the new old agency road. All right. We will not be practicing our roundabout today. All the posting that's gone on that. So Old Dog will be the ride leader, and right before we leave, y'all can kind of get with him. Any questions? Please take a cue sheet. Please take a map. Please be careful turning left onto the, pull over to the right side of the road safely, exit your bike, push it over. If there's any traffic, get on the multipurpose trail when it's safe. But only do so when it's safe, because that's really the only, but that's basically what we do all the time anyway. It's either that or make a U-turn and come back, still the same danger. But get with him, get a cue sheet. Ride along with somebody that knows the route. We'll be going out old agency to Livingston, turning right on Livingston. Livingston turns into Lake Cavalier. Most of us that ride out here know that loop. We'll go up, make a loop around Lake Warman, turn left on Coker, go to Pocahontas, turn right on Robinson Springs, turn right back on Coker, come back to the stop sign there at Lake Cavalier, come back Livingston, and just do it in reverse. If you want 62 miles, when you get back to Pine Haven, when you get off the trace, turn left, go to the next left, turn left, go to the stop sign, turn left, come back to the parkway, turn right. All right. It's all on the cue sheet. It's all on the cue sheet.
Do we have to go up Cavalier Hill?
No.
Too bad.
Mookie. Turn around and come back.
Okay.
No, but y'all see him pushing his bike up there. He does have a little heart. Y'all go easy.
If Tom rides off, let him go. Don't chase him down.
Yeah.